All right, what's up? I'm Sade, and we're diving deep into the planet of Pluto, finishing off our eighth house segment. So, what is Pluto? Pluto is the planet of death, destruction, and transformation. Or maybe I should say, it is the planet of death and destruction so that we can have transformation. Because sometimes, in order for us to really change, we have to go through some shit. And Pluto showcases that to us unapologetically. Pluto is the planet that is the ruler of Scorpio, as well as the planet that is the ruler of the eighth house. Wherever you have Pluto in your chart, it will let you know that this is an area of your life where you can expect to experience deep transformation. And transformation that on the outside, it may feel like it's breaking you down, but really it's to build you up and make you stronger, to make you a higher version of yourself. Because if you remember, Scorpio is the scorpion that transforms into the eagle, that transforms into the phoenix. So you have to die. And Pluto reminds us these things in your life have to end so that you can have higher consciousness, be more of an alchemist internally of yourself, so that you can have the desires of the life that you really want. Pluto really comes in and rips the band-aid off of your eyes to the illusion that you've been living and shows you this is really what's going on beneath the surface. And if you want things to change, sometimes I have to pull the rug from under you, rip the band-aid off of your eye so that you can really see this is what's actually going on and this is what needs to change in order for us to have a better life. So Pluto is not really graceful in the way that it comes into your life. It likes to come in. It likes to shake things up, but it's shaking things up for you to learn your personal power. That is all Scorpion energy is about, is realizing that nobody outside of you has power over you. And sometimes when we become dependent on people or things and we become very comfortable and stagnant in our life, Pluto comes in and says, no, this is not how it's supposed to be. And I'm sorry I have to do this, but I have to literally shake your world up. Sometimes in a very domestically violent way, depending on where you have Pluto in your chart. And in other ways, things ending, death. Because Pluto is all about changes and transformation, it can bring up a lot of phobias and fears. So let's say, for example, if you have Pluto located in the seventh house of relationships, it can be a person who has a lot of fear when it comes to losing a partner, or maybe the reverse, someone having fear of losing them. So it can bring in these controlling tendencies or these obsession tendencies. And what Pluto does in the seventh house of relationships is every person that you meet is going to show you if you become dependent on them in a way where you view yourself as being your partner instead of being an individual. Pluto then sees that energy happening in that seventh house and it rips the rug from under you and it forces you to realize that you are not your partner and you have your own personal power and you need to tap into that or else you will not be able to have successful relationships in your life. What if you have Pluto maybe in the eighth house? Pluto loves to be in the eighth house. However, no matter where Pluto loves to be, it never makes it easier. Wherever you have Pluto, it will always be a challenge. So just accept it, lean into it, and embrace it with grace and compassion. If you have Pluto in the eighth house, Pluto is showing you your fears. You have fear when it comes to death. You have fear when it comes to intimacy. You have fear probably when it comes to not being in control, wanting to control. So what does eighth house show you? If you have a fear around money, then I'm going to rip all of your money away from you so that you can see that it's not about money. If you have a fear pertaining to death, then you're going to have a lot of death happening around you. If you have phobias pertaining to marriage and intimate partners, then I'm going to bring a lot of people in your life that are going to leave you, and you're going to have to see that you are your own power source. Pluto really shows us, because we have to expect constant change in our life, that we should never be attached to people or things. Learn to live through life, connecting deeply on an intimate level, but knowing that change is inevitable, so we cannot attach ourselves. And wherever we try to attach ourselves, Pluto then comes in and it says, oh no, you're getting too dependent and stagnant. So now I have to shake shit up. So go ahead, check to see where you have Pluto or Scorpio in your chart and really think about where in these areas are you holding on to attachments? Are you holding on to fear and control? And see if you can use Pluto's energy of deep transformation, of being the alchemist that you are. Use that energy to lean in to that discomfort, lean in to the unimaginable, but realizing that because you are your own power source, that no matter what happens, you will be fine with whatever Pluto takes away from you. Pluto is never here to keep you in pain. It's just reminding you that pain is part of the process. All right, that's all we have for today for the planet Pluto. Next, we're going to dive into Sagittarius and what Sagittarius brings from that ninth house and Jupiter. Jupiter coming after the eighth house of transformation and death, and Jupiter gives us that hopefulness of new life and learning new things and just taking the world by force. Thanks again for joining and tuning in to my Astro segment, and I will see you for our next segment.